My brothers and sisters in Christ, today the Church celebrates the memorial of St. John Eudes, a lesser-known saint, not because he had little impact, but for us as people of the parish, the Cathedral of Sacred Heart, he is as responsible as the perhaps better-known saint, St. Margaret Mary Alacoque, in terms of the spreading of the devotion to the Sacred Heart. But aside from that immediate applicability, and therefore of his being of particular interest to our community, St. John Eudes can be summarized in one way that I think is the ultimate takeaway from his day, which is, by the grace of God, you know, when we look to see, when we see something that needs to be done, to not look for others to take care of it, but to step in and do what we can do. That is a model of Christian mission and charity. And so St. John Eudes wasn't famous for just one thing. He moved about through tasks in his life from, you know, he was ordained in a priest in his 20s, moved, you know, between religious communities. He aided during two different plagues. He devoted his life to taking care of people infected with plague. Then he tried he founded two different religious communities, opened seminaries. He saw the severe need for reform of the clergy. He went about preaching missions, you know, the sacrament of penance. And then, you know, even at the end of life, helped found a house of foundation to help take prostitutes off of the street, those reforming, looking to escape the life they had been in. And in each of these cases, his work wasn't something that was cooked up one day and, you know, just in prayer with his head in the clouds, but, and not to say that prayer is head in the clouds, but, you know, sometimes we have great visions we contemplate these great ideas of things that would make the world a better place. And there's a place for that. But sometimes there's also just seeing the need before our eyes, a human need, and responding to it. It's a type of moral agency and charity that we see human need and we do what we can. Perhaps we can't be perfect in our solution to it. Perhaps there's someone with better skills, or perhaps it needs more money that we can throw at it, but we do what we can. And when we respond, we're channeling the spirit that moved St. John Eudes, which was to see a need and to try to address it. So when he saw the need with clergy formation, he attempted to open seminaries, and he met great resistance in doing it. The story even around his founding of the House for Recovering Prostitutes was even more famous. He did it after he was scolded, kind of mocked by someone who thought that, you know, he was just a pious man going about to do his, you know, doing his thing, and challenged that, you know, if he had a real heart, he would help these people. And so other people could have been angered by that, of being mocked. And instead, he actually heard the plea and tried to do something. He realized that even though he was being mocked, that it was out of a need, that there were people that he could try to help. And so he did. My brothers and sisters, we're not equipped, and God doesn't ask us to be super, to have every gift in the kingdom, to be able to do everything ourselves. In fact, it's a great spiritual danger to think so. But he does ask us to be his hands and feet. And in love, when we do what we can for the human need that's in front of us, the world becomes a better place. The love of Christ is known when we see need and we step up to it. There's another day for better solutions, fuller solutions, but when we see a person in front of us that needs our help and we offer it, when we see something and say, I can do something to help here, what a better world we live in for this. St. John Eudes, promoter of devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, in whom we place all our trust, the same St. John Eudes, pray for us.